It is a beautiful sun splash day, Thursday of the National Eucharistic Pilgrimage. Here we are in downtown Springfield. We are taking Jesus into the secular world. It's going to be an awesome day to take Jesus into the streets of downtown. I know we're going to get a lot of looks, and that's important because we want people to see our faith. We want people to see that what we believe is true. Jesus is present in the Eucharist. We hope it inspires others. It's already inspiring us.
Just interested to see kind of the reaction on the streets that Jesus might get, and just all of us walking with him through the world. It's just a very interesting concept that isn't often done, and you know, the world misunderstands Catholicism, so I'm just interested to kind of see what it's about.
The Eucharist for me was incredibly important for my conversion. Learning that the Eucharist has always been considered the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ was just something that was so profound that it's become really the center of my Christian life. And being here, I just hope to honor him and show, you know, faith that us, the Catholic community, can show the world that we truly believe what we preach, that the Lord is present in the Holy Eucharist.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, probably, and I'm trying, as I get older, to be more involved in the Church and Eucharist, and I thought it would be really fun.
I just need to feel closer to the Lord, closer to the Eucharist, and I thought this would be a good way to do that. Just follow the path of Jesus and follow him through town.
Adoration is one of my favorite things to go to, and so the very first time I felt this baby move was actually kneeling in front of the Eucharist at Adoration a couple months ago, and so that was, I just felt like God spoke to me and gave me a lot of peace on this pregnancy and the health of the baby, and so that was probably the most prominent one in my front of my mind.
When I was in Iraq, I was actually a Protestant prior to going to Iraq in 2009, and I had a little trouble at home, and I had to go see the preacher, and it turned out to be Father Amalari at Balad, Iraq, and I got to see him, and I got to feel the power of the Eucharist shortly after completing the RCIA, and it's like no other. I encourage everyone that believes in Jesus Christ to work their way to taking the Eucharist as much as they can and go to Mass as much as they can.
Community has had a long theological grounding in Eucharist as meal, as sacrifice, and as real presence. And so today we celebrate that real presence. And we know tomorrow we'll continue to celebrate the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the meal that Jesus is among us.